Thank you so much. So, this is the Peter Frampton Band right here. And they're the best band.
She loves you!
So, anyway, when I first came to America, I came to record an album called Frampton's Camel. And that was... I'd been to America with Humble Pie before that, but this is my first recording in New York with Eddie Kramer was the engineer producer, and so we came over from England, and we said, Eddie, look, it's just the three of us, we don't have a drummer, he exploded 2 weeks ago, and do you have any good drummers in New York? He laughed, of course, because there's a billion. So he gave me three numbers. First one didn't answer, second one didn't answer, and the third one, John Siomas, who's on the live record and all my albums, he answered, and so I got him to the studio, and fantastic track we did, which is the one we're going to do now. And I just said, would you join the band? He said, yeah. I said, well, you got to do something about that drum kit. I mean, it's awful looking. It's all different colors, and I think different makes, right? So I said, what would you like? Well, I've always wanted to get one of those big Ludwig kits with a big bass drum like John Bonham. So I said, okay. So I ordered a white one for me and a green one for him from Ludwig. And then he left the band at a certain point. And then a few years after that, even Tech came to me and said, Guitar Tech, and he said, Pete, I think I found John's green drums on eBay. So I said, you've got to be kidding. I thought, there it was. So I had to buy the drum kit for the second time. And I just don't understand it. It was so much more expensive the second time. I don't really get that. I've not worked that out. Anyway, the wonderful end of the story is that the beautiful green kit that I got back has been in my studio for many years now. We cleaned it up, and it's sitting right over there. We are celebrating the life of John Siomas, and also one other person that's left us. And you know his name if you've got my live album. I don't know. He was my brother for many, musical brother and dearest friend for many, many years. And you know his name because it's on the live album, as I introduce him as Bob Mayo on keyboards, Bob Mayo. So this is an ugly.
strangers that loves me to a bed. Kept on trying, buying time, not waiting on fate. Somehow I got the feeling family and friends.